Dusty, say hi to the vlog. Say hi to the vlog, Dusty. Juju, the people missed you. People have been looking for you, Dusty, on the vlog. Nasaan na daw si Dusty? Nasaan na daw si Dusty? Ayun lang si Dusty, guys. Oh. Sobrang nagpapakit lang sa akin araw-araw. Lambing-lambing talaga ng pusang to. So, say hello to Dusty, guys.
Yo, YouTube, Carlo here. Welcome to the vlog. This is the channel where we talk about sneakers, life, and tech. And for today's episode, we are going to check out and unbox and put on feet a pair of Adidas shoes and a pair of New Balance sneakers. So, both shoes are my latest pickups. Over the weekend, we were actually at BGC, so I just want to put them on feet, unbox them, share them with you, and then I'll share with you also what are the different sneakers available that are interesting over at Adidas. So if that interests you, keep on watching. Tara, let's go. Before we get to the shoes, I just want to share with you guys, they have a new face mask. It should have better design and it comes in, well, bigger sizes. This one is in all black, but along the other side, it actually has three stripes. So you have the Adidas branding over here and then three stripes on the opposite side. So you just put it on your face and yeah, fits much better compared to their original face cover that they released. My only issue with Adidas face masks is that there is a tendency, because this material is so flimsy, yung the internal lining, that when you are speaking or when you are breathing, that you actually kind of suck the inner layer inside and it covers your mouth or your nose. But yeah, overall, much better fit. I like the look so much better compared to the previous one. And yeah, best face cover of Adidas so far. Yeah, it's 900 pesos for a pack of three. That's definitely pricey considering you can get the Uniqlo face masks, which are approximately the same quality, if not better, for like half the price. So this is the Adidas Ultra 4D 5.0. So this is in size 13. I usually go half or a full size up. I don't mind it being roomy. Take a look at that. Ba-bam! So you have the gray prime knit 5.0 upper of the Ultra 4D. You have different shades of gray with white to give it a little bit more accent. I just love the look. I mean, it's a really muted sneaker considering that you have that same color of the 4D tech for the midsole. And then you have this bright pop of pink, orange, salmon for the heel clip. So I just like the overall look. I mean, you can wear like an all black outfit or even like joggers and then, you know, like a white shirt and then use this to top it off. I just feel that it's such a versatile, nice looking gray shoe. Now, when it comes to the 4D sneaker, I've done several reviews of 4Ds, including the Ultra 4D. And if you haven't watched it yet, the summary is they need a break in time. If you wear them longer, if you beat them up, they become a little bit softer. The initial feel that you get is that it is a bit firm, but rest assured, after wearing them for a couple of days, lumalambot siya. It's nowhere near the Ultra Boost experience, but it does get better, okay? So it's more of an aesthetic thing more than anything else. This one is pricey AF. SRP is like 14,000 pesos. If you ask me, if you can get it at a discount, much better. I think that it will go on big sale in the coming weeks ahead since they are just sitting on shelves. There's no hype behind them. So abang-abang na lang kayo sa sale kung gusto niyo ng mga 4D na ganito. This mask is really growing on me. I mean, I really like it. Parang if not only for that annoying inner flap talaga eh. It is a really nice mask. But yeah, Adidas face cover. Now, if you are wondering why I am wearing a colored shirt for today, I'm actually set to judge an award show over here in the Philippines online, obviously via call. It's called the Tambuli Award. So we will be judging the best, or I think digital influencer category. So feeling judge, you know, feeling expert. So that will take up most of my afternoon. But I do have a couple more minutes since it is still before 1 o'clock. We are still on lunchtime and I'll unbox for you guys one more shoe. So wait a minute.
Rumfold, say hi to the vlog, Rumfold. Say hi to the vlog. Say hi to the vlog. Cute. The second shoe that I have is from New Balance. So this is the New Balance 992. This one's a really nice shoe. Now my problem with the 992 is that they are a bit tight, especially for people with narrow feet. Especially in the 4 foot section. So yun lang yung challenge sa kanya. But I couldn't resist buying this because the color is just ridiculously awesome. So, ba-bam! Take a look at that. I already wore this actually. Wore it once. And I just love the shoe. I mean, I love how it looks. I love how the style just complements a lot of the outfits that I have. But I hate this tight forefoot section. This part over here, especially this part where that leather hits the toe the bone of your big toe, it's just so annoying. But again, I don't think that will be a problem for most of you guys who have narrow or normal feet. Yung mga tao lang na katulad ko na higanting pa ang may problema dito, especially if you're wide, the wide part of your foot is the forefoot section. But yeah, in terms of style, in terms of look, versatility, and premiumness of the materials, my God, this is a really nice shoe. Add to that it is made in the USA. So the quality is on point, the build is on point, the design is just insanely good. But again, my problem is the sun. I'm actually hoping that if I wear this some more, if I wear it maybe, if I break it in like a couple of days, just like the 4Ds, that the toe section would be looser so that it won't keep on hitting the toe of my big bone, because it really gets uncomfortable after some time. Talaga si Dusty. Dusty, do you like the shoes, Dusty? Dusty, do you like the shoes? Oh, it's the same color as your eyes, oh. The box is the color of your fur, and then the shoes is kind of like your eyes. Ang cute talaga ni Dusty. But anyway, so what do you guys think of the New Balance 992? Let me know in the comment section down below. As usual, would love to hear from all of you on your thoughts about this sneaker. Man, it looks really nice. Okay, so what are the available sneakers over at Adidas BGC? So for those who are interested, I'll do a quick run through of the shoes that you guys might find interesting. Well, to be honest, there's nothing like super hype. It's really just a mix of really good, nice looking GRs. So for example, we have a mix of the new Ultra Boost 6.0s. You have it in the white and blue color, which I actually wanted to buy, but they didn't have it in my size. And they also had the 6.0 Ultra Boost Parley, which I did an unboxing of. So if you guys missed that, I will link it down below. They had the Ultra Boost 21 Parley edition as well, which takes on the same vibe of the 6.0 in terms of look. Very clean, very fresh, very timeless silhouette and colorway for the Ultra Boost. There were a bunch of other Ultra Boosts, the Ultra Boost 5.0 in gray, in black, a ton of Ultra Boost 21s in different colors just sitting on shelves. We also saw like a bunch of 4Ds, ranging from the gray Ultra 4D that I just showed you guys earlier. There was a black and blue version, and there was even like still the Parley 4D in the cream off-white color. Now, if ever there's like an interesting shoe that I almost wanted to buy just because it was super cute and it wasn't that expensive, it was actually a Stan Smith collaboration with Marvel. So if you take a look, it's your typical Stan Smith, but the midsole used some sort of like brown cork. I don't know what material that is, but the nice thing about it is that it's Groot inspired. So you actually had Groot on the side at the back of the heel. It's just a really nice shoe, and it says "We are Groot." And I guess for geeks and for people who don't take themselves too seriously, they would enjoy wearing something like that. And it's just not that expensive at 4,800. Get used to vouchers, much lower, wait for the discount. But unfortunately, again, they didn't have it in my size. But if they did, I definitely would have copped that one. It was such a nice looking geeky shoe, no? Anyway, so yeah, those are the only things that caught my attention over at Adidas VGC. Nothing too hype, nothing too crazy. Most of the good stuff drops online these days, not actually in physical stores. So, yun. So at this point, we actually have a very quick Carlo Eat segment. I'm cooking steak, ribeye, and then I'll see you guys back here. And then we'll close the vlog from there. Yo, so in today's Carlo Cook segment, we are cooking ribeye steak. Yung isa is actually even Wagyu. So, I super love cooking steak. It's like one of our favorite foods here at home, obviously. So, this one naman is from Deli Master. So, they're a deli beside our house. And this one is the US Wagyu ribeye gold. Tingnan nyo naman yan, no? Price per kilogram, 5,252 pesos. So, just for this one, it's already 1.8. What? Tapos, this one naman is cab. Ano ba to? Australian ba to? Angus ribeye. So this one naman per kilogram is 2.2. Tapos this one is 629 pesos. So kung makita niyo yung difference, this one has more marbling, yung Wagyu. Kaya mas maganda yung lasa niya, tsaka yung flavor, tsaka softer siya. Versus yung marbling yung mga puti-puti. Sa to, kita nyo, mostly dito sa mga kagilid-giliran lang. So, yan, let's prepare it. Salt, pepper, cast iron pan, butter, thyme, let's go. So yan, so we're cooking the ribeye first. Now, like what I mentioned in my other cooking videos na steak, if you are going for a medium rare, ako ang style ko, either pwede mo hawakan to get the feel of it, or pag nakita mo umaakit na yung dugo, parang that's a good sign already that
pwede na yan. So, pwede mo na i-flip. So, antayin na natin ng konti, flip natin, and then yun.
So yan, kaya na guys.
Okay, and we're back. So I hope you guys enjoyed the food. Anyway, so I just have one quick reminder for you all before we wrap up the vlog. We did announce a new giveaway over at the Unbox Green Hills Instagram account. So Unbox Green Hills is our new shop for toys, sneakers, and other collectibles that's opening in June. So as early as now, we're doing giveaways so that we can build the community. So if you guys are on Instagram and if you want to win really nice NBA cards, it's actually linked down below. Check it out. Make sure to follow Unbox GH on Greenhill so you can be part of the giveaway. We already announced the winner of the LeBron Funko Pop giveaway on the same channel. Okay, so that's actually it for today's vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed. As usual, this is Carlo signing out. Peace. God bless. What's up? Boom.